I'm thrilled to be here tonight to present the Miles Alumni Service Award to Monica Stevens. You created in honor of former Dean Ray Miles, who is with us here this evening. This award is presented each year to an exemplary volunteer who cares deeply about Berkeley Haas. Monica received her MBA from Haas in 1996. Since then, she has worked tirelessly to champion diversity and inclusion initiatives that benefit Haas and its students. I've had the opportunity to work with Monica in her current role as the chair of the Haas Alumni Diversity Council, and I'm personally inspired by how passionate she is about making Berkeley Haas a welcoming environment for everyone. Monica's direct style enables her to be effective in driving tangible outcomes for what is often an emotional issue. Her guidance helped to shape ethnic diversity and gender equity initiatives that were encapsulated in the Berkeley Haas Strategic Business Plan. And under her leadership, the council has hosted numerous events for minority and underrepresented students, helping the school to make great strides in outreach to these groups. She goes beyond herself to help potential students navigate the application process and to make sure that the student experience shines for all members of the student population. Monica, thank you for placing a premium on inclusiveness at our school and for everything you have done for the Berkeley Haas community. Please join me on stage to accept the Raymond E. Miles Alumni Service Award.
Thank you, Erin, for the wonderful introduction. The only thing she got wrong was my year. I graduated in 2006. I wish. That's right. That is right. So thank you, everyone. And congratulations to fellow honorees, Dr. Nanaka and John Hankey from 1996. I'm just gonna claim it. Let me tell you a quick story, and only 2 minutes, Tinny, about how this girl here traveled to where I am tonight, particularly as the first African-American female to win this award. And I was, thank you. Thank you. And I was particularly honored to meet Dean Miles tonight and his son and spend time with him talking about his history and my history, and they are so similar. So for me, that was really the theme of tonight, of how similar we are. I also want to tell you about how my co-pilots and the defining principle, although Chancellor, you did a fabulous job of stealing my speech, worked and continue to work for me. So, I'm gonna start at the beginning. I was born, maybe that's too far back. I was in the Navy. Oh, that's still too far back. Thank you. So let me start with students always. That's always a good place to start. I came to Haas, yes, last century, to make a critical career pivot from real estate lobbyist to real estate finance. Thank you, Mom and Dad, my original co-pilots, for making that pivot possible. At Haas, I learned just enough to convince Wells Fargo to hire me. So thank you, Haas. Thank you, Wells Fargo. Thank you, Professors Wallace and the Chamberlains who are here, because without them, I'd still be on campus crying. after I graduated from Wells Fargo, I'm just going to say it, 21 years ago, my daughter said, you just mumble, no one will know. And continue to have an amazing journey. There, my co-pilots have been many, and some of them are here with me tonight. So thank you, Patty, thank you, Nancy, thank you, Ray, and thank you, Lisa. So I was lucky enough to return to Haas, still my co-pilot, and recruit the best students in the world, right? Who are confident without attitude. So Vanessa, Ramey, and Delaney are here with me at the Wells Fargo table as exemplars of that. So it was during one of these visits where I ran into Dean Lyons, and he had the nerve to question my status quo. And he asked me, what would it take for me to come back on campus to get more involved in Haas? So I may, with a little attitude, have put my hand on my hip. And I questioned his status quo, and I said, rejoin this organization that was key to making Haas more diverse and inclusive, and then we can talk. And quite frankly, I left campus thinking, there's no way he's gonna do that. Particularly in the post-Proposition 209 era. So do you know what he did? I bet you know what he did. He and others went beyond themselves and rejoined that organization. And as a result, Haas looks and feels better. Take a look around next time you're on campus and you will see the fruits of those efforts. So what happened afterwards? Well, we started a diversity alumni council. We hired a full-time employee to make sure Haas was more equitable and inclusive. Thank you, Dean Lyons. Thank you, Joe Magnus. Thank you, Susie Jordan. Thank you, Tenny Frost. And the Alumni Diversity Council, all of whom worked really hard to make that happen. And finally, Tenny, I'm almost done. None of this could have happened without the support of my family and longtime friends. Thank you for helping me stay the course through this journey. You are also my lifelong co-pilots, Steve, Elizabeth, Kent, Dana, Craig, and Amy, thank you. And of course, I could never forget my dear husband, Paul, my fabulous daughter, Annadella, my most special co-pilots, who give me the runway and freedom to go beyond myself. So friends, guests, please share this story and your story with other young folks, boys and girls that you know, about how co-pilots and defining principles have helped you give back to Haas, and help them imagine of how far they can go. So thank you very much. Thank you, Dean Miles. Thank you, Dean Lyons. Go Bears.